surface, because these people never had any backing, they never had any resources, they never had anything to live and pay their expenses, because of the poverty of the justice movement, as it's been the case for so many generations. Then they decide they're going to operate in a double Trojan horse sustainable strategy. They buy little businesses, they buy banks, insurance companies, dry cleaning establishments, fast food, all kinds of little businesses they buy, which they call a sustainable sub-economy. And they put forth the best practices inside these businesses. But it's also an intelligence operation, because it gets them inside the trade associations. So when they take on all these lobbies in Washington, they've got people inside all these places feeding them information in advance, which is critical to the way this narrative evolved. And then they deal with access to justice. Let's face it, most of us are shut out of the courts. Most of us are shut out of these regulatory agencies. And so they target that in a very prominent way. Then they say you got to excite people. You got to have it person to person. They don't believe in just working through screens to mobilize people, like the internet. So that they take Leonard Riggio, who grew up on the streets of New York, is now very rich, and he's in charge of perfecting how you get people out in lunchtime rallies in the center cities all over the country, where they're usually squares, and also for marches. And then they recreate parades. Parades are resuscitated all over the country for issues, not just, you know, rah-rah parades, but parades that collected with, like, solar energy. They have these great solar energy festivals that are extremely provocative, because they're pivoted on the sun god and the sun goddess. And this is considered sacrilegious. So a lot of these radio shows are thunderously denouncing them, including two very prominent right-wing radio talk show hosts whose name are Bush Bimbao and Pawn Vanity. Okay. So then they have to organize people in their roles as workers, consumers, taxpayers, voters, etc. They create a clean elections party to get all these electoral reforms through Congress. And the party pledges that after it fields the candidates and gets the reforms through, it's going to go out of business. So it's just a one-platform party. Now they, in the first 4 or 5 months, they really plan very privately their coordinated endeavor. Although publicly they go out and they get a lot of press on their own issues. They're trying to find out how do they get millions and millions of people to contact them.